Well, the first time I met Tim was the first, this is our third year of the Access and Inclusion Awards. The first year was 2013 and we advertised for people to put in a short film. And Tim, I hadn't met Tim before, he put in a film. And as well as showing his short film at the awards event, which had, you know, it was 200 people, in front of 200 people, he also stood at the podium and talked about his film and why he loved filming. And it just blows people's stereotypes about what people with intellectual disability or people with disabilities can do, you know, do have the courage to stand up in front of a whole auditorium. I've known Tim for a while now, and because he's been submitting films to our awards, and he's shown me quite a lot of his, because he volunteers also as a council volunteer, he comes and works in my office, and he shows me his latest films and photos.
I'm involved in this project because Tim has been volunteering with me once a week to help take photographs of work I'm doing in council. We became aware of the possibility of getting a Run Project grant and talked about some ideas. And Tim was pretty keen, so he applied and was successful.
And I thought it'd be nice to show them how much we love filming. The project to show disability how we're your story and we're your how learn from the story.
We've got three participants who will work one-on-one with Tim to think about and film or photograph aspects that tell their story. Their life story and their what their goals are for the future.
Hi, my name is Tim. I enjoy bowling. I'm here today to do films and photos. I wanted to make a documentary for a while now and just film the people like of Quatsaw in the buildings and yeah.
My life, my story, my goals. So my life is like share your life. Story, when you're filming, you can, that's part of your story, and it's one of many things for disability. And goals. Goals is you learn from it. You learn from yourself, and one day you can be a producer like me.
I just take pictures around our house and animals and anything I see, and be guided to do a movie, and learn how a movie is, and how to produce, and all that sort of thing.
Personally, I like to do it, because I love my friends supporting, and it would be nice to show them who they are and what they do.
Well, I think this project's really special, because it's an opportunity for us to tell Jesse's story.
Exactly, yeah.
You know,
yeah.
And it's a great story.
Yes.
They have a wonderful, you know, she has a wonderful life.
Yeah. Tim had some ideas about who he thought might be interested with people that he's been involved with through LifeBridge and other places. And they were invited and they agreed to be involved. It could only be a small group because the funding is not, it's only a small grant.
Hey guys, welcome to our workshop to Friends from Morrissey. So we're going to start on talk about media. Now, what is media? I'll ask Tim a question. So Tim,
yes.
What's media to you?
Media is filming, photos, any of the sort.
Today was the first meeting with the three participants that Tim will be working with. The purpose of the meeting was to make sure that the participants understand what their involvement will mean, what they need to prepare and what they need to think about in being able to tell their story. And then from then on it'll be learning about the equipment and then going out and actually doing the filming.
End of December the 3rd, the people might say, hey, these people are good. They are professionals. It's like Jess. She's in the band, ask the band, and every time she plays something, that's why I love saying, hey, I can do this. I'm not scared. It's hard to spell, it's hard to write and stuff. But sometimes we can try. You don't have to be scared. You can do things men can do.
Can I ask a question?
Yes.
If we were here at the Kingslip Cinema tonight, you know, and we're watching the final cut of the production, generally, Karen, question to you, how do you think that would unfold and what it would look like?
Well, the idea that we've talked about, Tim and I have talked about, is having a film from each of the people involved about their life, their story. Yeah. And then there would also be, the fourth film would be Tim's film about him managing the project and showing people how to film and going out with them and assisting them and that kind of thing.
Okay.
So because Tim's thing is that he's developed this really great skill and he thinks that anybody can learn how to make films and take photos, and he wants to show other people that they can do it.
Yes.
So that will be his. He'll be filmed and filming, be filmed doing that. So in our heads we had three short films and then a slightly longer documentary, but that could change as the project goes along. It's really up to the person. It's up to Jessie. If she, like I know Tim, wants to actually be the photographer and the filmer. He wants to learn, is that right?
Yeah.
He wants to take a film and learn to use the equipment himself, so he will make the film.
Okay.
If he wants to be in it, then he would have to organise that as part of the film. But it's up to Jessie. If she wants to learn, Jessie, if you want to learn more about taking photos or making a movie, Tim can help you with that. Or if you want it to be about you and the things you do in your life and someone else to take it, that would also be okay. So it's whatever, it's your story, basically, and it's about what you want to learn.
And yet, how did things go today?
Today, it's wonderful. It's wonderful to see them out there and share your stories and photos and film and storyboarding. It's a wonderful thing.
People are already perhaps skilled and creative at taking photos because it is, as Tim's explained, a wonderful medium for expressing yourself or showing your life. A photo can be 1,000 words. So I suppose this is Tim's project, but it's everybody here's project, as I see it as well. So
it occurred to me in the meeting today that the kids, the young people, young adults that are sitting here 10 years ago, 20 years ago, wouldn't have had the same opportunities and the depth and the breadth of the capabilities of doing what they're doing without media, without Facebook, without the internet. They can virtually do what able-bodied people can do intellectually because a lot of the applications and the programs are easy to use. They're simple to use, and they can take you to places that ordinarily, in the past, people couldn't go. I think people with perhaps intellectual disabilities or would be sitting either watching TV because the only way of getting stories or connecting with people were through books and reading, and the other media was television. So I guess even before that, I mean, we could say once again, people 100 years ago or 50 years ago would have been restricted to basically dialogue with their loved ones and not necessarily had a bigger world as we have now. I think now's a really good time for people to be alive that have these disabilities because they're not so confined as they were.
Okay. Well, what we're going to do is take some photos and film for the board.
So should we go
out? Let's go out and take some photos, eh?
Hey, that's clear.
Go there.
All right.
All right, so what we're going to do is get the person who want to walk in, take a photo, and then the next instruction is the person sits down on the chair right here. Take a photo.
That's right. Try to walk naturally.
So I think you just sit like that and just look out there.
Yeah.
Okay. You look out there. You look out there. Now it's the best side.
That's a good one.
Just take a photo of everyone just talking between themselves.
Okay.
Take a photo of Scott filming you. I'll get a face shot.
See? You don't
see that?
I need that.
Can you zoom in to get it?
No, it's not blurry.
Just the faces.
Fine.
So zoom in, just get that nice orange scarf.
Alright, you ready for some good photos?
Yeah!
Oh, alright, let's go.
Alright. Go have a look at these photos.
It's really exciting and it's also inspiring to see Tim in particular grow through the project, to have the opportunity to teach other people what he's learnt with the joys of photography and filming, and that's what he hopes to get out of it as well.
How do we get the photos, Tim, from the camera to the laptop?
Well, I can show you that now. What I do, put this USB plug into this camera. So it's got a USB card right here. Just plug it into this.
Right.
And then, if you want to see the pictures on the computer, turn this one on. That's all your videos and pictures in this folder.
Is that the one we took of today?
Yes, every one of them. So then, you can edit them and put under 3 or 4 minutes of it.
So can we see the pictures? How do we put it on a slideshow?
Oh, well, I can show you that. So preview.
Yeah.
I took this shot because I didn't want a too much closer shot, like not in your face kind of that shot. But this is a good angle right there. Where she's smiling.
The different angles of the planking and the corner.
Yeah, I tried to put in words.
All right, I took this shot.
That's it.
That's me. I was about to delete that.
There is a selfie setting on there. I don't know where it is. I'm not in the selfie age group.
Yeah, I looked up.
I like that one too.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah, I think it's really good shot. Mm. The way he's sort of doing the pose really well, and just show the background of him, see the background.
I zoomed down on that photo to get all the frogs, then I zoomed in to get them closer up.
I didn't even know they were frogs, so you've got a good eye for detail.
Yeah.
I wouldn't have even thought to take a photo of that, so just the simple fact that you thought to take a photo of that, because I would have just walked straight past it. So you've got a good eye.
Start, simply drag and drop videos into timeline. Then it's easy to trim, rotate, split, speed up, slow down, and much more.
So when we meet in June, in a month's time,
mm-hmm.
one of the participants, they can bring a set of photos or a small film they've done, and you can actually show us how to use that software to make changes.
Yes.
And edit. Okay.
Yes, that's right. That's
like
probably,
put in music, yeah. Change sound effects, put
that's
in text,
right.
All
yeah.
That kind of thing. Great.
Yeah, that's my plan for the workshop anyway.
Yeah, excellent. That would be really great. Really good.
What have you stained it with?
Well, you get a special stain for Bunnings, special oil. It's called stain oil, but it's a special name for the oil, and you put it on, and then it comes up really brings out the colour on your table.
Thank you.
just click one.
Yep.
And then press the top button on here.
Import. And can you select a few and then import?
Yes.
Okay.
It's no music.
So you have to go to the place where you have actually stored your music.
Yes.
When Tim was born, another form of media that I lent heavily on was music, lots of it, loud music, stimulating music, music all the time. And Tim was dancing way before he could walk. And I stimulated Tim with not only music, but tactile feeling things, you know, hot, cold, water, deep water, things that would surprise you. And I haven't run out of things that surprise Tim. So to stimulate somebody is the key to growth. And I think as adverse as a media can be, is with Facebook and stuff being problematic on one end of the scale, on the other end of the scale, it's so helpful and so vital for kids with disabilities of every range so that they can connect and be part of the society we're in.
Clip, and then we go down to auto, and then drag your auto down to zero, because you've been using that'd be a good idea. So you want the light plug in there?
Yeah, not too.
Videos? And then we're gonna do, make it interesting, is this one here. And then we're gonna add some photos as well.
The art part of it is choosing those, which effects to use exactly. To make the photo or the film look even more interesting is what he's just really, really great at. Because
yeah.
you like doing that, so you explore it a lot, don't you?
You want that in there?
Excellent bike. Where's
the excellent bike there?
And shall we create a new folder for interviews with you?
Yes, please.
Yep. So if you click on here with the and yep, and right click. Yep, and then see what says new sequence from clip.
This one?
Next one down. New sequence from yep, so click on that. And it'll pull one up. So then click on here where it's got the neural, yep, click on that. And type in Tim interview.
I'm very excited for me to be in the short film at Kingscliff Regional Cinema.
Mm-hmm.
I like, yeah, to be noticed. And I will tell them this is my first short film ever, and it will be very exciting for me. This is the cafe I have coffees. My fiancée Shire at Hastings Point. I am walking to the beach.
Thank you.
So what have you learnt, Jess? What have you learnt through this experience?
Taking photos.
Yeah. And what program did we learn to use? What did we use? Can you remember what the program
iMovie?
Was? iMovie, and it was really good, wasn't it?
And it was fun.
Lots of fun.
Lots of things I can use and do stuff. Mm-hmm.
And what's Lifebridge asked you to do this Halloween for the day? What's your job on Halloween day?
That's the photos at disco.
Oh, the photos at the disco, is it? You're going to be the person that takes all the photos?
Yep.
Then you might put it together in a movie and send it into them.
Yep.
So if it wasn't for this project, we wouldn't have had a clue how to do that, would we?
Exactly.
I enjoyed taking the photos and meeting new people and did my own short film, which I'm very proud of.
So Beth, are you keen to do this again, if it's happening again?
Yes, I am. I've been always making films and movies, and I'm looking forward to next year, or when they have it, and sort of give me more confidence as I do it and every time. And it's a wonderful thing for me to do. It's really great.
I want to make another short film next year, and photos as well. Yeah.
And have you got some ideas of what you want to do?
Make a short film in Moolumbah, or even at bowling. I do 10-pin bowling.
What was the best thing about the workshops?
Just making a movie.
Catching up with us.
Yeah, you guys.
So fun.
Yes, it was.
Tim was an excellent teacher. I wouldn't have had a clue what to do.
Me either.
I tried very hard to do it myself, but to no avail. So I rang up Tim, and within a couple of hours, we pretty much had our whole movie done. So I was blown away at his skill level and what he could actually do.
I'm involved in myself is to learn to communicate with people, and I learned from a lot of people. Up to next year, a new film festival. This year, we finish after tonight, so we're all proud of you guys, and well done.
States jammed with gunners like me, afraid of coming in last.
And thank you.
We're coming undone when days go by. I can feel it flying like a hand out the window in the wind. The cars go by. It's all we've been given, so you better start living right now. These days go by.
This is my life story of the things I do in my life. Here we are now sailing, which I like. And now I'm doing my beadry. Now down at the beach on the machine doing some exercise. Out for lunch, and that's at King's Golf Club. And we had a good time. Oh, this is our tree of the crowds we're putting in. I'm walking along the beach here now. And I've been to lots of barbecues. People's asked me to barbecues. And I like going to Bodhi, which I hadn't been there for a few months. This is in Melbourne. Went to a lot of markets there. And here I go, taking out the tree for the koalas. And we've got Pessimina's ground really hard. I'm mulching around and they put all wet and stuff all over it and the soggy, that though it's raining. And then they put these mats around it to make it all dry and mulch on top of the mat. They plant it around approximately 700 trees or more, the koalas, and they have more eucalypts in the leaves. And they go there, and they have more food. what they were, where they were before. It keeps them more healthier. There's a lot there for the koalas to do. And they look after their babies that way too as well. They're still planting more trees there as well. And next year it's going to be around about approximately 830 trees altogether.
Probably a week, I guess. Yeah, about a week.
It only took you a week to make all that?
Yeah.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
And what have you stained it with?
I get a special stain for bunnies. Or they get it themselves in for like an oil on it, special oil. It's called stain oil, but it's a special name for the oil, and you put it on, then it comes up really, it brings out the colour of your tables, of the stain, and that's what it gets on. So there's other free stuff.
How do you use the table now, Beth? How do you use the table now? Where do you keep it?
Well, I just put it in my room and I put a cover on it and my lamp goes on there and I put a few other things behind the lamp and then another thing, but I have it like a plastic cover over it, that's my cover.
I like it because it's so original, like there's not another table that looks like that, and it's really an attractive table.
In a way, I run for Trish, but hers hasn't got the toy, which I wanted to do. But hers is a thing underneath, like a bench and her table.
This is the Cafe Ive Coffees. I like to walk on the bridge to relax.
Well, I know a place where love flows like water. You sit on the bank and pass the time away. So take my hand, I want to show you something. My very own lover's hideaway. And I'll take you down to the...
I am walking on the bridge.
Where we'll be loving in the shade of that old willow tree. I'll take you down.
My fiancée Shire, Hastings Point. I am walking to the beach.
Where you and I can just be. I see us now, lying underneath the heavens, and sipping on wine, with nothing much to do. Just you in my arms, and while the sun is setting, we're making sweet love in the light of Mr. Moon. Take you down to the river, where we'll be loving.
Hello, Tim.
Hello, Tim.
Welcome to my workshop.
Yes.
I'm going to ask you some questions and see what you like about the workshop about yesterday. What do you think about that?
Well,
Yesterday at the workshop, I was very impressed of how it went, and yes.
And
it worked out really well, all the discussions about the short films and,
And what you like before to try this film at Kingsfield, what do you think about that?
I'm very excited for me to be in the short film at Kingscliff Regional Cinema.
Okay.
I like, yeah, to be noticed and all that.
Okay, and what are you going to say to the audience and what do you say to you when they come up to you?
I will tell them this is my first short film ever and it will be very exciting for me.
And are you surprised about all this is happening?
Yes, I am.
And are you feeling excited to share your story and your life at the cinema?
Yes.
Okay. And one more last question is this. If you made a film on a life story, what do you think about what film you'd like to make next year?
It'll be probably at Mawulumba or Tweed Heads.
Okay.
Or somewhere else. Not sure yet.
Okay, that's fine. Thank you for a nice interview and welcome to 2015 Tim's Story.
August the 4th, 2015. And thanks to my family and my fiance Cherie Wern. And thank you.
Baby, I'll be a man of my word. Speak the language in a voice that you have never heard. I want to sleep with you forever, and I want to die in your arms. In a cabin by a meadow where the wild be
like a hand out the window in the wind. The cars go by.
other night, I watched the world flash by. Headlights, taillights, running through a river of neon signs. But somewhere in the rush I felt, we're losing ourselves and days go by. I can feel them flying like a hand out the window in the wind. The cars go by, it's all we've been given. So you better start living right now. Days go by. Oh, well. Yeah, the days go by. Oh, well. We think about tomorrow, then it slips away. Oh, yes, it does. We talk about go by. I can feel them flying like a hand out the window as the cars go by. It's all we've been given, so you better start living. You better start living. Better start living right now. As days go by.